Good morning. Today I've gone for a little outing in my kayak. I'm on the Mediterranean, just off the coast of the province of Alicante. Given its proper name, Alicante. The sea is pretty calm. There's a few little waves. But nothing too unpleasant. The first summer. I'm using this kayak. And I'm enjoying it very much. We've already gone on a few outings. Cafe that's about 4 kilometers from here. But today we won't be traveling that far. Today is just about enjoying the motion of the waves and the sound of the paddle as it runs through the water. A little further out to sea. Right now, we're just beyond the swimming zone. It's marked out by some yellow buoys that can be seen not too far from here. Let's take a look at the buoys. It might be a little small to see, but directly in front of the nose of the kayak right now is a yellow buoy that marks the swimmer's zone, beyond which recreational craft are not allowed to pass. It's very early in the morning, and there's only a few morning walkers strolling along the beach. And the sea is empty. The only people there with me are a few ships off in the distance. And to the north of us, we have some mountains, which are shrouded in morning haze, shaping up to be a beautiful day, and soon the mist will burn off with the morning sun. Sunrise was quite spectacular today. As I was setting up my kayak, the sky was filled with pinks and peach colors. It takes a little while to get started with this kayak. Because it's actually inflatable. It's inflatable, but it's very stable. Because it's made of a material that is drop-stitched and can withstand enormous pressures. So it actually gets inflated to 8 pounds per square inch. I believe that's somewhere in the region of half a bar. That means that when you touch the kayak, as I'm doing now, it actually feels as though it's full of styrofoam or some other hard but slightly giving material rather than just full of air. So it does feel like a very stable craft. And although it has 2 seats, I have been taking out 2 of my 3 children. So there are 3 of us on it because it can take up to 220 kilos of weight, which is more than enough for me and 2 kiddies. I could even take the 3rd, but she's a bit afraid of getting on the kayak right now, as she's only little. I expect that next summer she'll want to come with us. Is a bit green still because it was windy yesterday and the waves churned up the water, churned up the bottom of the sea and moved a bunch of algae around. But it looks like today it'll settle and the sea will return to this beautiful blue color that it normally has. North. You can see this area of coastline is quite built up. There's a lot of tall buildings here. Unfortunately, a lot of the coast here has been developed without much control. Still, this is a relatively well-kept part of the country. The beach is treated very well by the people who use it. You don't find much rubbish lying around. And the waters and the sands are kept clean by a team of people who work in the mornings to pick up anything left behind by anyone who hasn't been very civically minded. This area of the coast is actually used mostly by Spanish people. A little further up the coast, in a nearby town, the town in fact where the cafe is, which we went to a couple of days ago, that town is mostly inhabited by English and French people. And it's not uncommon to see shops. usual tapas and freidoria, which you get in this part of the country. Down towards the end of the headland, just where my finger is pointing, is a lighthouse which flashes away every night, warning ships of the coast. And you can't see it right now, but over in the haze, a little off to our right currently, in fact, I can just about make the silhouette of it right now. It may not be visible on camera. Directly ahead of us right now is the city of Benidorm. Benidorm is famous as a destination for Brits traveling to Spain to have parties, and for people retiring in Spain who do not wish to have to make the effort of learning the life or the language here. Each their own, I suppose. I prefer to mingle with locals when I travel to a place, and to enjoy the local foods and the local customs. I am very much a food-based traveler, and I tend to choose places that I will holiday in based on my love of that local cuisine. And we'll spend the next couple of weeks here, just enjoying the beach, the sun, the pool, and popping out in the evenings for the occasional meal or the occasional ice cream with the children. It's a very relaxing type of holiday. It's especially nice because over here it's actually nice, cool, clement weather compared to where I live. So it's nice to come and spend some of the hottest summer months in a place which has a temperature just a few degrees lower than the temperatures in the city I live in. Then we'll head further north to spend another couple of weeks with a family in the village I'm from. That is much further north, about 4 or 5 hours north of here by car. And there it's hot during the day and cold at night, because it's pretty high altitude. And it's a very different landscape to here. Surrounded by foothills and pine forests and olive fields and almond fields. And the current seems to be very gently pulling us out to sea. And in fact, just in the distance in front of us is a stand-up paddle surfer. One more person has come to join me in the sea this morning. I have a little Velcro pocket. I normally keep my telephone inside this pocket, as it's essential to take some form of communication with you when you go out to sea, in case you should need emergency assistance. Shells. These are shells that my son found the other day over on the beach further north from here. Our beach has plentiful shells and shell pieces. This beach over here. Beaches that are made up of sand and brick. broken shell pieces. And he found some beautiful natural bay that keeps the waters pretty calm. As the land reaches out into the sea on either side of the beach, the sun is lifting higher into the sky, creating beautiful reflections on the surface of the water. I applied some sun cream prior to getting in the boat, as sun here stings quite a lot, despite it being early morning. And my skin has not got the highest tolerance possible for the sun. I think I'll start to paddle back towards the land. I can go home and have a little breakfast with the family before heading down to the beach later in earnest. Hope you've enjoyed spending a little time out here with me at sea. It's one of my favorite things to do. It's so peaceful. And it's an excellent way for me to get some exercise. Although it's my morning, it might be your evening. And I do hope I've brought you a little relaxation, and maybe even a little sleep. Until next time.